with integration by parts. But before that, one more time. Then integration by parts. So it is simpler than this. Normally what happens, no, in integration question, whenever they want you to do a complete integration, they don't ask everything. For example, they will ask you, this will be P times this plus Q times this. What is P?
Oh, okay.
Integrate not everything, but you should know that, okay, this result is already coming in my answer. I just have to find the coefficient of that term. Just find it out. Solve it. You don't have to complete the process. Depends upon the question asked. It's very rare that they would ask you to complete an integration, you know, to get the answer. So before we start integration by parts, we will take these twin functions. Of the form these shapes are very important, especially with respect to school exams. Okay. Now in order to explain you this process, please note that sometimes this one also may not, this term may not also be there. That means it may also have integration of this step. So both the types, the approach is the same. Just listen to the approach. Let me take an example of this type first. Let's say x square plus 1 divided by x to the power 4 minus, let's say, 3x square plus 1. Right now, do you have any idea how to integrate this? Would you like to try? Just try for 2-3 minutes, see if it gives you the result. Yeah. Any idea? Sharanya, any idea?
Oh, no.
Shali? No, sir? Okay. So here the approach is, we divide the numerator and denominator by x square. Okay. The benefit is, not very evident, but it's seen all the time. Correct? This is what you'll get. Now, 1 plus 1 by x square is differentiation of which term? 1 plus 1 by x square is a differentiation of which term?
X minus 1 by x,
right? So take x minus 1 by x as t. Okay? So that we get 1 plus 1 by x square dx as dt. So my numerator will become dt. Right? What will happen in the denominator? Do you see this term is actually t square plus 2? So can I say it will be t square plus 2 minus 3? Correct? No? You just square it, you get x square plus 1 by x square minus 2 is equal to t square. So x square plus 1 by x square is equal to t square plus 2. So this term here, you can replace it with t square plus 2. Good enough? So we'll get dt by t square minus 1, which resembles the formula of x square minus a square, correct?
Wait, so what
did
we
mean?
X square minus
3
by x square. Wait,
no. You divide it by x square first. Yeah, what is the answer to this? Shweta, what is the answer for this? So put back your t as x minus 1 by x minus 1 by x minus 1 by x plus 1. you may take the x LCM on both sides, so x square minus x minus 1 by x square plus x minus 1. Is the idea clear? This is the very, very commonly asked type in your school exam, so be very, very clear with the concept, with the algorithm.
X square as t.
If it helps, take it. That's why I told, try it out. If you take x square as t, you should have an x dx on the top, yeah, which is not available. Okay, now here, one quick thing. Had there been a minus 1 here, the approach would remain the same till this step. You will take then x plus 1 by x as t. Is that clear? Should I give a problem on that time?
Yeah.
No? Sai? No. Fine. Okay. If there is nothing, what do you do? Let's say, I take an example of this type. Let's say dx by x to the power 4 minus 3x square plus 1. How do I integrate this? Please allow me to clear this if you have copied it. Vishali, copy it. Dipanjali. For such cases where there is no term on the numerator, what do you do? I tell you a very simple thing. Multiply and divide with 2. Okay. Now this 2, you write it as x square plus 1 minus x square minus 1. Alright. Then we separate these integrals out as x square plus 1 and yeah, you have both the forms now here. You have to do it both separately, each one of them. So you know how to do this. Divide by x square, take x minus 1 by x as t. Divide by x square, take x plus 1 by x as k.
How do we know what to manipulate to get
more? You know the form, no? These are the two forms. Both the manipulations I have told you. I am making you manipulative. One favorite question that is asked in this type is integral of root tan x, and I got this for my board exams.
Oh,
wow.
Board exam. Hey, why what?
When you struggle with the question, you definitely remember it for the rest of your life.
Did you solve this question?
Yeah, but after a lot of struggle.
This is not that type.
So this side, yeah?
Oh, so you have to write tan x, yeah, 1 plus.
So think how it is of this type and then how do you solve it?
Sir, you have to write.
Try it. Everybody try it individually. Think you have got this for your board exams.
Board exam.
So,
but then
how
will we know that it's this type,
that it's like this? I also didn't know that. But suddenly then you'll come to a form and then you realize, oh, it is of that form. Yes. Pardon me? Well, Dev, why do you do that? To artificially generate x square plus 1 and x square minus 1. I know, initially it will not psych you. But once you see this, at least that idea will be there in your mind. I can't do that. Hint. Hint is everything here.
So you have to write tan.
Multiply and divide with c square x. And then substitute tan x as t square. See what will happen. Multiply and divide with c square x and then put tan x as t square. See it. Multiply and divide with. Correct? This part is fine. Write the c square as 1 plus tan square. And then I ask you to take tan x as t square. Correct? So that c square x dx is 2t dt. Correct? Now when you substitute here, you get t into 2t dt by 1 plus t to the power 4, which is 2t square by 1 plus t to the power 4. Is this what you are getting finally?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now this 2t square, by God's grace, can be written like this. Correct? Right?
Oh yeah.
And then again by God's grace, we can write it like this.
So how many marks did this question have? Four.
There's 4 marks. Okay, so this problem stood between me getting 100 and 96. Okay. So then divide by t square. So you get 1 plus 1 by t square by t square plus 1 by t square.
So how long did you spend on this question?
15 minutes, I spent.
What does it say? How many questions?
You would realize when you start getting integration in your school exam, the only problem which is a black hole for you is the integration problems. They will kill a lot of your time. They are known to kill a lot of your time. Alright, so in the first one, what do you do? First one, you substitute. What do you substitute as some other
variable?
T minus 1 by t. Let's call it as p. Which implies 1 plus 1 by t square dt will be equal to dp, right? So it will be dp by, correct me if I'm wrong, t square plus 2, correct? In the second one, we substitute t plus 1 by t as, let's say, k. So currently I'll get dk by k square minus 2. What is the answer for this? 1 by root 2 tan inverse p by root 2. Correct? What is the answer for this? 1 by 2 root 2 ln of k minus root 2 by k plus root 2. Now start putting your things back. Put your t for, p in terms of t first. So it will be 1 by root 2 tan inverse t minus 1 by t, and t is your root tan x. So root tan x minus 1 by root tan x by root 2. And in the second expression, you'll have 1 by 2 root 2 ln k minus root 2 will be, k is root tan x plus 1 by root tan x minus root 2 by root tan x plus 1 by root tan x plus root 2. I have no place to write a C. You can simplify by multiplying with root tan x on the numerator.
It's
a
default.
So imagine the fate of that poor child who got this in the board exam.
He wouldn't have studied. He was the only one to solve it.
Sir, you got
100.
99.
You would
have to
solve
this. 1 mark,
you lost 2 marks. I think
1 mark
I lost in probability. Okay, is this clear? Now there is a twin problem for this. Root tan x plus root cot x. That is simpler than this actually. Even though there are more terms, this is more difficult than solving root tan x plus root cot x. Will you like to try? Integrate root tan x plus root cot x. Again, a very famous problem. You may come in your school exams as well. Then same approach, exactly the same approach. Question is, so you should be very clear where to take x minus 1 by x as t and where to take x plus 1 by x as t. Your numerator term will decide that.